Okay, I'm back. I was up moving. I also went and I wrote down the waterfall measurements and that photo layout one in my design projects workbook. I have one of those downstairs too by my computer. So that when I watch videos and I see something that inspires me, I can write down their measurements if they give them, or how it looks, and figure out my own measurements. Or if I get struck with, hey, I want to do this, and I got an idea for something, I write it down there. So that's my ideal book. Okay, my birdie. No, he's got face up. I'm sorry. This pocket on. I have to remember this if I ever do another one, is to get all my pieces cut and put where I want them. That way, goes a little bit faster, not much. It does go faster, let's put it that way. Because this bottom paper here is glittered, I'm using a little extra glue just to make sure. Okay. I guess I'm going to have to go buy some more tape for my ATG. We have just one more after this one to finish up, and then these will be done and I can figure out how big of a spine I need. Did I already do that? George, I did. Okay. Yeah, I've been thinking more and more about having a drawing. You guys see how many subscribers I have and right now and see. So I think my last count was 23. I'm getting there. I'm new. It takes time. I know that. But, maybe if I got up to 50, I'd do one. Oh, that stripe with that paper looks really good. Didn't stick down for a minute, too. Okay, I don't have a problem with those. Alright. And I am loving this fine tip. One thing, it fits in better than my other ones did. There, that one's done. Now, this one gets the large pocket, which I'm gonna just make and then because I'm not gonna put it on the center yet. Problem with working with black. Sometimes it can be hard to see. I still need to change out that light. I keep forgetting. Yeah. This one I'll go this way. Back of this one is, because I got the two pockets I put on, and then there's the belly band. How hard is it to put on a belly band? Not that hard. Belly bands are easy. Unless you screw them up somehow. that is done. Whoops, not done. I put on the other side. Slow down. Okay, so that is done. So let's do this side. That's the back. That's the side. Okay. Okay, that was throwing me off. So for this, it's going to get these two pockets here. So it's just a matter of folding them on the designer paper. Think about it until after I made them that I could have taken them coin type pockets. It's all right. That way. All right. too antsy. Gotta slow down. Alright. Sometimes yes, no. What I'm doing there is some, even though it's an overall pattern, sometimes it looks better one way than the other. So all I'm doing is looking to see which way I like best. Even though it is an all pattern and there's really no right or wrong way. It's just that sometimes, depending upon how you cut them, they look better one way than another. Alright. You see, this one you definitely... Okay, that is the back. Oops, come on. I'm not supposed to stick down yet. There we go. This piece here, there definitely is a right and wrong. So I'm going to score tape the back. Let's see. I like that. I end up going a little further back. Anybody waiting for the new fall season to start? I'm waiting for my favorite shows to start. Before I forget. I got several favorites. I like the NCIS. They're going down to New Orleans. I also like Person of Interest, Criminal Minds. I've been watching Unforgettable. I think that one's kind of cool. To be able to remember everything you've ever experienced, saw, did, whatever. I gotta catch up on Rizzoli and Isles. Of course, then you got Storage Wars and... Storage Wars looks good because they've got someone coming from Texas and, what's his name? The Gambler's son supposedly is all agaga about her. So, that should be interesting. And then Brandy and Jared have their own show now. They're actually kind of a unique couple because they run a secondhand store. I know at one time they had two and I think they had to close one. But, that's how they make their money, is they run a secondhand store, so they go ahead and they buy those storage units to stock their store. I can imagine at times it can be very frustrating if you need stock and you can't find it. In those storage units. Dave Hester supposedly does an auction house. Okay, and this one gets the belly band. So this pocket is going to go in the front. There's my belly band. You know what, I'm just going to use this one. I've got it in hand. So it's kind of interesting watching these people and that and seeing how they, and I know a lot of people are complaining because now the prices have gone up on the storage lockers because of this, of shows like Storage Wars and that. But you know what was bound to happen? I don't know if any of you have ever watched Extreme Couponing. You know, where these people use coupons and get... I was watching some reruns and, you know, there's a downside to that too. I mean, some of these people, to me, they kind of seem like hoarders because they go in and they clear the whole shelves. They buy things they don't need. Like, one lady was buying dog food. She doesn't even have a dog. And I could see if she was donating it. I do know that there's some of those couponers, they actually do their couponing for charity. And I think that's great. I like that. So... I mean, I've used coupons. I've had Great Days couponing. Nothing like what they get, but... But I mean, when I go and look for supplies and things like that, I use a coupon. In fact, I gotta go get more ATG tape. Guess what? I'm using a coupon. I'm using several, in fact. All right, last one. It's inside B. Okay. That's the front. That's the pocket. That's back. It's inside B. I gotta organize them to how I put them on, so. So here's the front. But yeah, I know, like Joann's, they do their coupon things, and what I really like doing is, because my husband's retired military, when Joann has their military appreciation thing, yeah, I go ahead and I take in all the coupons I can, and I show my military ID card, and get the discounts. But, I mean, I bought an Otlite, and it was on sale. For one thing. I mean, it was like half price to begin with. And then I used my military ID card and got another 20-25% off it. Which, and I bought other stuff too, so I mean, I didn't go in there just by the Otlight. But by the time I got done and everything, I, according to their thing, I had saved over $200 and some. And that's including an Otlight with a magnifier. So. I thought that was a good deal. This on. Start it this way. There we go. Well, yeah. I look for sales. I look for ways to save. Like it's Stampers Ink and Ink Paper Rubber. Is it? Yeah, Ink Paper Rubber. I'm part of their rewards program. You spend so much money and then you get so much off, or you get so much credit, let's put it that way. Usually it's like you spend $200, you get $20 worth of credit. But then Stampers Inc. also does Double Punch Fridays. So if you go there on Double Punch Fridays, spend $100, you get, you actually fill up a card. And you can use them together. I mean, right now I'm sitting on three of them. I don't know what I'm going to buy with them. I just kind of save them until I find stuff that I want and then I go buy it. And if it's more than I have budgeted for that time period, that's when I use those. So that it really doesn't cost me that much. Okay. There we go. Okay, that side's done. Yay! We're in the home stretch now. Because this is the last one. The only thing I got to cut for it is the large waterfall. In the next page I do. What I think I'll do is I'll put the paper down, do my back, because that is, if I put my back down. So yeah, when I get this pocket on, then we'll do the large waterfall. And then all that's left is to put the paper on the back. I've already got the back part done. Just kind of scared me to do it when I was doing the other one. I think that shifted on me. And then I can see how big this is before I add mats and everything, because that will help determine how wide of a spine I put in. I'm thinking it's going to be 4 inch. But he's gonna work one day, so we don't have any plans for Memorial Day or Labor Day. That's okay, because I can get some housework done, finish up my book. But I imagine by tomorrow I'll be pretty good. And decorate. I got a whole bunch of flowers. I bought pearls. I have ribbon. Got plenty of ribbon. Can't find my doily, so I'm gonna put doily on. I think what I'll do is go out tomorrow, because I gotta get more ATG tape. And I'll pick up some doilies and yeah, I know normally I would do the, I just want to paper this. Actually, I'll do the center thingies last, because I just got to put them together. Slow down. Make sure this is not shaped right. It's good. The main part's done. Yay! The main part's almost done. That's the big thing. Actually, I'm kind of glad I started it when I did. Because otherwise I'd really be scrambling. There we go. Alright. See how big my base is. 6x8. So these are 6x4 to half. cut this to 6. Do 4.5. Here's the nice thing is I'm doing them all on the same side. That way there should be no issue with size. I know there's some controversy over whether you should flip them. Like if I was doing a half side on this, half inch on this, whether I should flip them. And you know, whatever works for you is how you should do it. Because you gotta make it work for you. You can't say, well, so-and-so says I gotta do it this way. Okay? But if so-and-so, does so-and-so craft like you do? Do they, are they in your craft room? The answer more than likely is no. Do you craft the same way they do? The answer probably is no, because everyone crafts differently. So do it the way that pleases you. Velocity Vet08, Jane on Velocity Vet08, on her blog, she says, crafting without fear. And that's exactly it. I mean, this is a big book. This is a big deal. This is something very meaningful and special. Am I crafting without fear? No, I am fearful. But I am still doing it. I am taking the plunge and doing this for this person. If I had been doing this type of craft, say 14 years ago, I would have made one for my Aunt Jeannie. In fact, if her kids like it, I may do one anyways and just give it to Nancy and say, here. So. Poppy, what are you doing? You can go to bed? You tired? Poppy normally doesn't go to bed until I go to bed. She may sleep, she doesn't go to bed bed. She stays up until I go to bed. She's also hoping if she comes up here, she'll get extra treats. There is a method to her madness, too. But anyways, I've got a real, I want to make one for my husband, and I bought some stuff that'll do it. And I also have some military paper, what I would consider military paper. It's got camouflage and all that stuff. So, should make one for him and just give it to him. I got pictures. But I got to find someone to take them off my broken heart, external hard drive. I was uploading stuff to my external hard drive, and the mittens decided to knock it off, so now the USB port on the hard drive is broken. So I got to take it in and see if I can at least get the information off of it. I bought another external hard drive, and the one I originally had was what they call a desktop model. So I need to see if they can get the information off of that and put it on my other one, which is not a desktop model. I think they consider it a portable model. All right, get this done. That's that lined up. Try it without miter and see if it goes better. It might. There we go. Yeah, I'm saying there we go as I do each one. I don't know, I guess that signifies it's done or something. I don't know. Just realized I was doing that. There. This way. What is that? Why am I saying there we go? I guess because it works. So maybe that's the magic words. There we go. it's done. I think what I'm going to do is do a slight trim on this. Come on. Get off of there. Wasn't talking to you, Poppy. I think I'm going to leave it just like that. I'll do a quick trim. Nice. Even it up. Oops, I need to go the other way. That's the way to do it. Go ahead and line this up down here. Take my ruler. This is probably the best way to do it. You can trim multiple sheets like this. Get it down so far you can actually take your scissors and trim it. That looks better. Okay. Hold on a minute. I gotta clean off my desk here. Tape it on the back. Extra pieces for those. All right. I want it to lay flat. So I think tomorrow when I work on this, I'll be working on the binding, the covers actually, because I'll know for sure how big the covers should be and how big the binding should be. Get that situated. There we go. Worried a little bit that it shifted, but it didn't. Okay. And then right. Oh, I lost them. All right, make sure I got this going the right way. So this will go this way. Sitting that there. I like that. Alright, let me get these done. Let me do a guesstimate on how big what spine we need. Thank you. wrong way. Oh, I know what I could. I've had bangles before and they usually taste sweet. Well, I have one and it tastes a little peppery. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Let's see. Put that there, that there, that there. But it tastes kind of peppery, and I thought, that's unusual. You know. It's normal. I don't think it should taste a little peppery, but the one I got, yeah, it does, so. Alright, I need to make sure. This paper is directional, but this piece goes in the same direction too. Yeah, I just thought it was strange. It was peppery. I gotta figure out what I'm gonna bring to the... In our families, it's tradition that when someone dies, we have the viewing, usually the night before the funeral. Then we have the funeral, and then you go either to a church, or you go to their house, or to a community center or someplace like that, and everybody gets together. And there's lots of food. Now, on my mom's side of the family, somebody brings a ham. Don't ask me what. It's not to be eaten then, but eaten later. It can be eaten, you know, then, but a lot of times it's put up and eaten later. But there's usually lots of food, lots of talking. A lot of reminiscing. And it's a nice time, I will say that. It is a nice time. It's just, gotta figure out what to make. I guess I'll start looking at recipes. Oh, I did saw a cucumber dip. That sounded good. I might make that. Bring it with crackers. Alright, so that's done. Okay. So those can go there. Alright. So that's our pile of flat folders. Yeah, it's going to be a big binding. I can already tell. Because as it stands right now, it's about 2.5 inches, just as it is right now, 2.5 inches. So let's say it's 2.5 inches. So I already know I got 2.5 inches. And I need 3/8 of an inch times 7 times. You would think 5 because it's just, but I also added between the front and the back. So 3/8 plus 3/8 equals 6/8. Plus 3/8 equals 9/8. Plus 3/8 equals 12/8. Plus 3/8 equals 15/8. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 6 equals 18/8. And 7 equals 26/8. So that is 3 1/4. So it might be a 5-inch binding. Well, it is expanded out in here, so I think if I do a 5-inch binding, because when you look at these two I already put the thingies on, and I mean I accidentally put the centers on, so these two alone with just that little binding are maybe 1/2 inch, so 3-inch. Big binding. Maybe I'll do 1/4 inch. Because that's 5 3/4. Well, actually, that would be 1.5 inches. 1.5 1/4 4 3/4. So if I did a 5-inch binding, yeah, I know it's going to be big. So it's going to have a 5-inch binding. And a half by 5 inches. So I'm trying to think. Now I know I want starts 1.5 inches in. I'm just trying to figure out some stuff here. It starts 1.5 inches in. That's the start. Plus 1.5 inches at the end. That's 3 inches right there. Okay. Now, you figure 1/2 inch. So you figure 6 inches. For the 1/2 inch. So that's 9 inches right there. Then you got the 3/8 of an inch, which is 3 1/4. 12 1/4. So I need approximately 14 inches of paper. I said approximately. And the way I figured that is 1.5 1/2 on each side, that's 3 inches. Then I need 1 inch for the spine gusset. So that's 6 inches. So at that, that's 9. And I already figured out the 3/8 of an inch that I need is 3 1/4. So about 14 inches. I'd do 14 inches of paper. Because it's 10 inches. I'm trying to decide if it'd be better to use 8.5 by 11, because I can take the cut them down to 10 and just leave the 8.5, and then cut off whatever I don't need. That's an idea. Okay. It's got to get 10, so I got to cut an inch off. I'll do both these at the same time. I'm not going to do this one. I'm just working out the mechanics of it. I might get scored tonight, but that's about it. All right. So, 1.5 inches is my starting point. Scoring with this one. Okay, so 1.5 inches. Okay. Then 3/8. That's my first gusset. Then I need 1/2 inch. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3/8, 1, 2, 3. Okay. 1/2 inch. 1/2 inch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what I'm going to do is go 1/2 inch. Essentially be right there. Okay. So that should be everything. Now understand, I don't have the tape in here yet, so it's going to be a little wonky. Yeah, that looks good. And I am going to put some, let's get my technical down in there. Tyvek. Yeah, I'll be putting some Tyvek in this as well. At least on the bottom of it. Well, it's on the cover. Okay. You can see how this is going to look. This will also help us see how long it is, or how wide it is. This is just a temporary thing. Okay. So there's our let's see. Put that at the 5. It's only 3 inches. How come I thought I needed so much more? I thought I needed a wider. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay. I thought my. Actually, I only need my spine to be about 3 inches. I was thinking 5. That's 2 inches difference. All right. So we got our spine worked up. Excuse me. And this is where I am calling it goodnight, because I am tired. So tomorrow, when I start taping again, we'll be working on the spine. We'll put down the Tyvek and all that. We'll get all this done. My measurement was off too. I needed 11 5/8. Oh well. Okay. It's better to have too much than not enough. So, got this figured out. We got 6 file folders done. So, that one's in the wrong spot. That one goes like that. That one goes there. That one goes there. Okay. They're back in order. They gotta be in order. So there's our file folders. Like I said, I'm not going to do a lot of embellishing on these. One thing, this takes up quite a bit of room. And most of the embellishments will be flat. So, that's it for tonight. We'll see you tomorrow. Ugh.